नमस्ते बिटिया, आई जेवीएन निशु शर्मा, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन मेथोलॉजी. टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज व्हाट इज वीपीओ, व्हाट इज केपीओ, व्हाट इज कॉल सेंटर. सो फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज बीपीओ एंड व्हाट इज केपीओ. सो बीपीओ मीन्स बिजनेस प्रोसेसिंग आउटसोर्सिंग एंड केपीओ स्टैंड फॉर नॉलेज प्रोसेसिंग आउटसोर्सिंग. सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ डेफिनेशन वी हैव अ basic difference between BPO and the KPO. So according to the definition, BPO provides service like customer care, technical support through voice processing, telemarketing, sales, etc. This is a function of BPO. But what is KPO? KPO provide in-depth knowledge, expertise and analysis on complex area like legal services, business and market research and many more. According to StrengthsFour, BPO stand for business processing outsourcing and KPO stand for knowledge processing outsourcing. The requirement of BPO and the requirement of KPO are, the requirement of BPO are good communication skills and basic computer knowledge. The requirement of KPO are specialized knowledge in a particular subject, in a particular field, in a particular area. In the terms of services, BPO have low-end services, but in terms of services in KPO, this is a very high-end services. In the terms of process, BPO is a predefined process, but in terms of process, KPO requires application and understanding of business. In terms of employees, BPO are not so qualified employees like 12th, BTech, BBA, BCom, BSc, First Sem, diploma. But in KPOs, the terms of employees, they have skilled and skills expertise of knowledge employee. In terms of expertise in BPO, this is a process, and in terms of expertise in KPO, this is for knowledge. In terms of relies, BPO is a cost arbitrage, and in terms of relies in KPO, it is a knowledge arbitrage. In terms of driving force, BPO is a volume driver, but in terms of driving force, KPO is inside driver. So basically, BPO is a capable of handling both front-end and back-end operation of an entity. Like BPO provides an array of services like customer care, call center, help desk, etc. Second one, human resources, like requirement and selection, training and placement, payroll processing. In terms of technical support, services related to finance and accounting, website services like web hosting, transactions, transcription. But the spectrum of services provided by KPO include investment research services, market research services, data analytics, business research services, and other legal processing, outsourcing, financial process outsourcing, media process outsourcing. So these are the KPO and the BPO. But in this video, what is the conclusion of KPO and the BPO? So almost all the transnational companies today outsource their non-core activities just to pay attention to their primary business. Both forms of outsourcing work in B2B environment, where the service provider and the buyer of service, both are business organization. One thing must be kept in mind that KPO is nothing but an extended version of BPO. Over the time, it has been observed that with the expansion of KPO, but the BPO is losing its existence. Now the service provider companies provide both BPO and the KPO service simultaneously to the organization. I hope after this video be clear what is BPO and what is the KPO. If you have any query, any doubt, then mention me on the comment box. Thank you for watching. This session is part of my digital version 2.0, Jayoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. Thank you.